Well, I don't get it. I'm seeing everywhere about InDesign CC 2019, CC 2019 Illustrator, InDesign CC new features, Lynda, all the big sites, you know, even Adobe here, Photoshop CC 2019. So everyone's talking about CC 2019, but what's interesting, if we go into our Creative Cloud, we'll see that 2018, well, CS6, we'll close that, open. 2018, I'll show you here, is version 13 that I have installed with CS6. They're both right here. But then it says here, instead of install, it says update. But I don't want to update, I want to keep my CC 2018. So I need to manage other versions, but it's not listed. CS6 is listed. And even if I go under 2018 of CC, other versions, it's not listed. Even though I'm clicking on it, I'm in it right now. Very strange. So I don't want to update yet because I want to install other versions. But I can't see that option here, only update. So I thought, well, I'll click on what's new. And the same thing with Photoshop CC, I updated that. Illustrator CC, same thing. If you click on what's new, you'll get the October 2018 release of InDesign CC version 14. So they're calling it, it's got all the features that everyone's talking about in CC 2019, but they're not calling it CC 2019, they're calling it the October InDesign CC release version 14. Huh. And up here, they don't even mention anything about CC October 2018, just that it's version 14. And if I click, by the way, on Illustrator, you'll see the same verbiage on the official Adobe site. We've been busy, CC October 15 release effectively is what it's saying here. So what happened to CC 2019? So if I'm on the Adobe site, if I search for CC 2019, and I don't really see any mention of it here. Like I just showed you, over, you know, all around the web, everyone's talking about CC 2019, so I'm really kind of confused. Now, it could just be me, you know, being a bit, you know, dumbo here, I don't know, but I just don't really get it. And I really need to because I need to keep CC 2018. I don't want to risk not being able to install that again. And I don't see it listed here anymore under any options to manage other versions install. So I guess that's my question. How can I install version 14 and keep version 13 of InDesign, which I have, which is CC 2018, clearly labeled here, you know, in this case, right there, and you see under About InDesign, it's version 13. So, yeah, a wee bit confused, you know. Anyway, what was really cool is a new Photoshop Express on the iPhone. Really loved playing with that last night. Kept me up to 2 o'clock in the morning. Thank you, Adobe. But I hope you can solve this little confusion I have. Maybe others have too. I don't know. What I'm going to do, I'm going to restart the entire computer, see if that helps with this condition, and we'll come back. Anyway, I'm going to record again here. I'm just going to show you up here. Yeah, I have a problem with an asset. That asset's been a problem since like day one. I don't know how to get that thing to sync. Anyway, that's a whole different story. Apps. You'll see here, it's still the same condition. You know, I can't choose to manage other versions and install CC 2018. It doesn't really, by the way, I also went up here and I went check for app updates manually just to see if that helped, but it didn't. But I'll just show you that, you know, just for the old due diligence here. Yeah, that's the one thing, Adobe. It's really confusing, this version 13, 14, October 2018 release, CC2019, CC2018. You use different things on different places, but not, you know, just keeping to the system. Or use all of them if that, you know, you could easily put here CC2018. This would be CC2018, like the CS6, and this should be CC2019, I'm assuming. Or then again, I don't know, because on the other hand, you're calling it October 2018 release. So I'm really, really, really just... Now I'm curious. I updated... Yeah, see, Photoshop's fully updated. I've got it fully updated here. So if I open up Photoshop, well, let's just open it from here to be safe. Oh yeah, see, it's a new version. I got it. That's pretty cool little screen there. That was wild. Oh, I got to sign in again. Hold on, guys. Close your eyes here. Okay, you can open your eyes again. All right, cool. Well, that's kind of wild. In any event, so here we are. If I go to About Photoshop CC, yeah. Version 20. Gosh golly. But it's just called Adobe Photoshop CC. So they dropped the 2018, but it does appear, if I open up this one, I still get the 2018 right here. And that's also just Photoshop CC, but their version 19. Boy, I'll tell you, it's just confusing. All right, so, but look at that. Now here in Photoshop 20, you do see that they call it the Adobe Photoshop CC 2019. Brother. So what happens if I open up something here? What's new in Photoshop CC? The October 2018 release of Photoshop version 20 rolls out. Where CC 2019? Well, let's search for it. Search for 2019. One match. I don't really see where that's matching. Oh, it's right there. Elements 2000. Well, I have to admit, this is like rather oddball. But what is good about Markzware here, and we're going to share something with you right now, live. I'm going to find it. I have still have to update it. I think I will now dare to update my InDesign. Let's see here. InDesign version chart. But yeah, I got a bunch of them. Here you can see a little bit right here, right? You'll preview. Well, that's a 2018 version. Okay, let's kick that puppy open in Illustrator 2018, not to be confused with the October 2018 release, which is actually 2019 of CC. Now I'm poking fun. I know I shouldn't do that. Anyway, so here you can see I'm going to update this now to include that version 14 of InDesign is now over here. I'm going to have to like compress things here, do like a select all and scale or whatever. Maybe that new, you know, AI for the image fitting will help me out. I don't know. But in any event, CC 2019 icon, which will look just the same like these, which is kind of a pity. I mean, come on, give me some flair, is going to be version 14 and IDML and all that, you know, stuff here. And you can check out our great chart and maybe even check out Mark's tools too to make IDML standalone when you're there as well. So now what I'm going to do, so I'll update that chart and share it with everybody. And what I'm going to do now, I'm going to quit Photoshop. How did Adobe become the industry standard in print and digital publishing? My short answer was Photoshop, including Illustrator, PostScript, and PDF. InDesign was the icing on the cake. And speaking of that, now I'm going to dare update my InDesign. Because I saw with Photoshop, it's actually a totally new version. I can quit 2018 here. And if you click update, it actually installs a new version and keeps CC 2018. And I'm sure Adobe will fix this. It's just a so-called mosquito. You're updating it. Well, am I updating or not? I mean, I don't know. Well, don't remove old versions. So make sure you don't click that. Oh, yeah, we'll just try it out here. Live on the wild side. All right, so we're going to let that download here, and we'll come back with progress as it progresses. I wonder how big the download is. This should tell you right here somewhere. You know, 5% of so many gigamahoos. Anyway, okay, I'll be back. Okay, that was a real fast download. I mean, really, that was super fast. Wasn't that big at all. KPN, my local internet provider, has given me a huge upgrade for all the business Markzware gives them over the years. Not really sure. In any event, now it's here. I can click open, but I'll show you. I mean, it's right over here in the applications. And you see all my InDesigns are happily there because that's exactly what I wanted. Kind of cool how they give the icon to the latest version. And I'm now going to do the honors of putting this down in my desktop here on that little thing. Hey, Illustrator, you're going to have to get used to 2019. I got to update you too. And I got to get the Photoshop over there as well. Boy, I got to get rid of that other Photoshop. The moment of truth, I'm going to kick open my CC 2019 for the first time. I'm going to move you out of the way. You want to see the nice, beautiful splash screen. I imagine a beautiful InDesign created. Jeez, is that a Halloween thing or is that like the end of the world? It's even like, you know, is that tar pit? That was kind of disturbing. I'm just having fun here, aren't I? So Adobe CC 2019, not version 14. Well, it is version 14, but it's not labeled. It's not the October 2018 release, which if you click on more information, what's new, that's what it tells you about. And it should tell us here it is version 14 indeed. Yeah. Well, sorry, you know, it is cool artwork. I mean, really, it is. It just was kind of, where's it? How can I get back to the splash screen? I guess you got to like restart. We don't need to do that. Anyway, it was kind of, it was like a little bit tar pity, you know? I don't know. Anyway, it was good work. You know, but I got to see that for the coming, what is it, year and a half, you're going to see that splash screen. That's really asking a lot. Okay, so CC 2019, none of the Markzware plugins are installed yet. That's what we're going to get on to doing right now. And, you know, all joking aside, there's a lot of really cool new features in InDesign. The, you know, way to automatically content aware fit your images. They've come out with some totally new cool apps, Photoshop Express, which open Photoshop Express. Yeah, like I mentioned, it was just really cool to work with that last night. And what's cool is you're in your app at 2 a.m. and you can go to share, get all kind of options, and you can go do share with Adobe Photoshop CC. So I did that, and it even worked in the old 2018 version. I came down in the morning, fired up the computer, and Photoshop fired up for me, and boom, there it was, that image I had been working on the night before, so I could finish it off on the desktop version. Very handy. So look forward to playing around with new InDesign, and I hope Adobe can help, you know, iron out these I would call them marketing snafus because it, you know, should be a lot clearer. Or maybe it's like a marketing, you know, trick or whatever. Maybe it's actually good for marketing. Who am I to say? In any event, that's the video. That's the wrap. Take care. Yeah.